As the globalization of businesses accelerates, so does the need for multinational firms to manage its subsidiaries. My research examines how a multinational firm manages, allocates its resources among its international subsidiaries. So take Bombardier, for example, a Canadian headquartered company. Its task is to allocate $1 million among its subsidiaries, one in Canada and one in China. The resource allocation must accomplish two objectives. Firstly, in an international setting, profits earned in different jurisdictions are subject to different tax rates. So the firm has an incentive to allocate resources to the low-tax subsidiary. In our example, Bombardier would allocate all the resources to the Chinese subsidiary to minimize tax. However, tax minimization is not the only objective. In allocating resources, the firm must also ensure that the allocation provides the appropriate incentives for the subsidiaries to collaborate. Here, Bombardier is interested in developing a new brake technology. The Canadian subsidiary holds the key research expertise and provides the research lab, whereas the Chinese subsidiary holds the material expertise and can identify the right type of material to be used on the brake. Because each subsidiary holds a key piece to the technology, the success of the project depends on their collaboration. And obviously, allocating all the resources to the Chinese subsidiary would hinder collaboration. As a result, the firm faces a trade-off between minimizing tax and facilitating collaboration. My research examines how a multinational firm best allocates resources in the presence of the two conflicting objectives. Besides its managerial implications, understanding this question also bears tax policy implications. Many countries hope to attract capital from multinational corporations by offering a tax rate reduction. My research shows that in the presence of the managerial considerations, a multinational firm may not always allocate more resources to the country that offers a tax cut. Therefore, it is important to understand when the tax policy achieves its intended effect and when it doesn't. My research contributes to this understanding by documenting their corresponding scenarios. Thank you.